far, but it still isn't there.
You're maybe better at the far, but it still isn't there.
You can never love somebody else's child the way you love your own.
The greatest prize can often lie at the end of the thorniest path.
Two midnights gone!
And the exhausted baker's wife had buried the dead Milky White.
Go, you must go back to the village in search of another cow.
And what do you say I use to purchase this cow?
Here, take this. Tell them it's magic.
No person with a brain larger than this is going to exchange a bean for a cow.
Then steal it.
Oh, steal it? Just 2 days ago, you were accusing me of exercising deceit in trying to secure the cow.
Then don't steal it and resign yourself to a childless life.
All right. But I feel best as if you go after the cow, because I've met a beautiful young maiden with a golden slipper, and I think I might succeed in winning over one of her shoes.
Fine.
Fine?
That's simply fine.
Just fine.
When is a white cow not a white cow?
Leave me alone, old man.
Haven't I left you alone long enough?
Your questions make no sense.
In need of another cow?
My cape, or I'll slice you into 1,000 bits.
I don't want it. I was just admiring it.
My granny made it for me from the skins of the wolf that attacked us, and I got to skin the animal. And the best part of it was she gave me this beautiful knife for protection.
Well, look what I have here, a hen that lays golden eggs.
I don't believe that egg came from the hen. Where do you get the egg?
I got it from up there, from the giants in his kingdom. And if you think that's something, you should see the harp he has.
Ha ha ha. Why don't you go up to the kingdom right now and bring the harp down and show me?
I could.
You could not.
I could too.
You could not. Mr. Liar.
I'm not a liar. I'll get that harp. You'll see.
As for Cinderella, she returned from her final visit to the festival.
He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him, he spread a page on the stairs. I was caught unawares, and I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace.
Don't you come any closer to me.
Oh, no, wait, please, just hear me out.
We have nothing to discuss. You've already attacked me once before.
I didn't attack you. I attacked your shoe. Here's the magic bean in exchange for it.
Magic bean?
Uh-huh.
Oh, nonsense.
Oh, no, don't do that.
I've already given up one shoe this evening, and my feet cannot bear to give up another.
Oh, no, wait, please, wait. I need that shoe to have a child.
That makes no sense.
Well, does it make sense that you're running from a prince?
Stop!
Oh, no!
Oh, no, wait, miss, here, take my shoes. You'll run much, much faster.
All right.
Who was that woman?
I do not know, sir.
Mine will cost you your life.
I swear I've done nothing wrong.
Oh, I'm the cow.
Oh, and I'm the slipper. We've all four.
Yes.
No! And we will search the kingdom for the maid who will fit this slipper.
Oh, no, wait, please. I need that.
Give her the slipper and all will come to a happy end.
What was that noise?
It was just a bolt of lightning in a far-off kingdom.
How dare you go off and search without me?
My apologies, sir. I thought that...
Enough of what you thought. I employed a ruse and had the entire staircase smeared with pitch. And there, when she ran down, remained the maiden's slipper.
Brilliant!
I thought so, though it did create quite a mess when the other guests left.
And I've succeeded in obtaining the other slipper.
Oh, give her the slipper and all will come to a happy end.
Who are you, old man?
When I first appear, I seem to leechier.
Shut up!
Do as he says. He's obviously a spirit of some sort. And besides, we only need one.
Yes, sir.
Been crushed? Well, there's nothing any of us can do about that, no, is there? I must be off. I need my rest before tomorrow's search is to commence.
Doesn't anyone care? A giant has fallen from the sky! Oh.
The third midnight is near. I see a cow. I see a slipper.
The cape is red as blood.
Hair is yellow as corn.
Move all the objects.
Yes!
That cow does not look as white as milk to me.
No, she is. She
is. This cow has been covered in flour!
Oh, well, we did have a cow white as milk.
Then where is she?
She's dead.
Well, I do prefer a live cow, so bring me the dead one, and I will bring it back to life.
You can do that?
No!
Wealthy Jack. As for the prince,
He began his search for the maiden to fit the golden slipper. When he came to Cinderella's house, the stepmother took the slipper into Florence.
Careful, my toe!
Darling, I know! What will we do?
It will have to go, but when it is bright and safe or bright, you'll never need to walk.
It was helped onto the horse by the prince, riding off to become his bride.
Look at the blood within the shoe. This one is not the bride, that's true. Search for the foot that fits.
And so the prince returned the false bride and asked the other sister to try on the shoe.
Why won't it fit?
Darling, still, cut off a bit of the heel and it will. But when you're his wife, you'll have such a life, you'll never need to walk.
No, no.
The girl obeyed and swallowed her pain. But as she was helped on the back of the horse by the prince, he noticed the blood trickling out of the back of the shoe.
Have you no other daughter?
No, only a little stunted kitchen wench, but she is much too dirty. She cannot show herself.
I insist.
And when Cinderella presented herself and tried on the blood-soaked slipper, it fits like a glove.
Aww.
This is the true bride.
And so the prince took Cinderella on the back of the horse and rode off. When the wedding was celebrated, Florinda and Lucinda attended, hoping to win favor with Cinderella. But as they stood by the blessed couple, pigeons swooped down upon them, poked out their eyes, blinding them. And it came to pass. All that seemed wrong was now right. The kingdoms were filled with joy, and those who deserved were certain to live a long and happy life ever after.
Turn over, turn over, all's mending. And it's not just for today, but tomorrow, and it's ending. Ever after, ever after, all the curses have an ending. The curse is wiped away, all this tenderness and laughter for forever.